skills in the ways of being a woman. I'm sure Polly thinks him a very pretty man.
Are you suggesting that our Polly, our daughter, should marry him?
If Polly is in love, how can we help it?
Have you no discretion? If Polly
married...
Where is my daughter?
In the other room.
I'll come directly. Mary!
Bill. Come here now, Bill. You know
me, for I must either lie to you or to Miss Polly. And I promise her, I will not tell.
But, Filch! What is a promise when the honor of the family is concerned? Come, Filch, come with me to my own room. I'll pour you a glass of cider that I keep for my own drinking.
Farewell. Cheers!
Cheers! But examine them, how genteel they are made. They will fit as easily as a glove, and even the nicest gentleman in England might not be ashamed to wear them. I leave you, sir, to your private meditations. Meditations! To what a woeful plight I have brought myself. Here I must be confined until I am hanged.
Such a fool as to be jealous of Polly.
Are you not married?
it. To convince you of my sincerity, if we can find the chaplain, I shall have no scruples of making you my wife.
So then, it seems you are not married to Miss Polly?
My dear Lucy, the girl is prodigiously conceited.
There's my father. That way I'd lace upon the chaplet, for I long to be made your woman.
Good lass. Let's seal it with a...
Thank you. soon be rid of the hypocritical stomachs. She thinks to pump some secrets out of me. I'll be on my guard and won't taste the drop.
Thank you.